next we'll talk about how to program this device, this controller, and we're using the Arduino IDE for this, and this is just a screenshot, so let's go and have a look. Let's go into this one here. You would download the firmware, that's the thing that the source code, etc., that is going to run on the controller as a zip file. And when you unzip it, you get a sort of folder structure wee bit like this. So this is the actual firmware in this folder. And I go into there, and you can see there's quite a number of files. There are two directories, one called data, which is for holding all the web pages, and the other for defines, which contains a lot of settings for things that you might want to enable. So let me just load it into the Arduino IDE. I've already got it running. But let's do that. And I'm using Arduino 1.8.19. And the reason for that is these data files that I mentioned about the web pages, they have to be uploaded to the controller once you've programmed it with the firmware. And you can't do that with 2. Whatever version of Arduino it is now. So I'll just minimize it, get it out of the way. So this is what the firmware looks like. And basically, I'm just scrolling down. It says, edit the file controller config.h. So let's go into there. And it says, OK. I've enabled this as a station, which is going to log into my existing IP network. And I'm going to get those details from a file which I've created called read Wi-Fi config. I've enabled the management server, I've enabled the TCPIP server, and I've enabled the web server. Notice there's nothing in here about anything else, about any other settings. You've also got web query, you've got OTA, updating the firmware without having it to be connected by USB cable, MQTT, ESPNOW, and this controller board is not running any sensors. So that's basically it. And because I've enabled this as a station, it tells me that it also edit defines station defines.h. So I'll go into there, and to do that, we'll just go back to this page, and it's in the data, and it's called, it's in the defines folder, and it's called station defines. So I'll load this one up, and we'll just pop it over to here. Right, so this is where I would change these details to match my Wi-Fi network that I wanted this controller to connect to. So that's where I would change it. And if I was using a static IP address, some people might want to do that. This is where I would enter those details for a static IP. And of course, I would change that configuration in the firmware file as well. This is where I would change that. So that's basically everything that you've got ready to go. And I've already added the ESP32 enhancements to the Arduino IDE. And because I've got all that configured, the next step would be to compile it. And you do that by clicking on this tick arrow, and it will go away and it will compile this. And once it's compiled, the next step would be to click this particular upload button and send it to the controller. Once I've done that, once I've sent it to the controller and it's finished and it's programmed, you have to create the default files it needs to run. And to do that, you would choose this option, ESP32 sketch data upload. Remember, this doesn't work in Arduino IDE version 2, but it does work in this version 1.8.19. And I would upload those. using this sketch data upload, and then when the controller reboots, it will find the default configuration files that it needs, and it will start running. So that's an overview of the compile process. Just leave that running there, and we'll switch back to here. And most features can be changed at runtime using the management server. I will cover that shortly, but to note that all the source code here is provided, and any configuring you can do initially in the configuration options, but most other settings, apart from Wi-Fi stuff, they can be handled in the management server. So something's not critical to do at compile time. Right, next we'll talk about the management of the controller, and most settings are available to be changed. We can manage it using a web-based server, or we can use a TCPIP client, or we can actually configure some things using MQTT. So let's just go and have a look at the management server, and we'll do that now. There it is. And if I know the address, and I do, because I programmed this before, 192.168.2.172, and that gets me into the web server. And if I want the management server, it's port 6060. So let's just do that. And you notice it asks me for a username and password. So I go sign in. And here are all the details that can be changed while it's actually running. So anything you see on services, anything you see on the MQTT client. And you notice there was nothing in the configuration file about pins and relays. This interface is where you actually select them and enable them, set the pin directions and turn relays on and off, etc. All that is handled by the management server. It's not handled in the firmware definition type files because it's just too complicated. So it's easy to do that. So that's relays pins. We've got OTA, which is the over-the-air service. We've got, you can define the colours of the various pages, you can list files, you can upload a file, you can delete a file, and you can reboot the controller. So that's the basic functions of the management server, and I'll talk about some of these individually shortly.